Hello. Day 323, Mega Songbringer. Today's the day after releasing the beta. The beta update. So, yeah, yesterday was a big update. Lots and lots of new stuff in the game. And there's still some things I need to work out. Patch the update, basically. What's up, Mighty Nest? Howdy, howdy. I was playing through the game last night, and there's a lot of things I noted that need to be fixed, but you know I'm only gonna get to like two or three of these, and then patch the update and stuff like that. Release. Basically, I'm gonna release because the code right now is in a state where I can release an update or patch. I'm gonna do that. So there's several bug fixes that are already in there that I've already done this morning. One is the mini map. There used to be a bad bug with the mini map. It was really bad because it would show certain areas on the minimap as you couldn't walk over that area. Like you couldn't go along a certain way. Let me get to the end of the game. I'll show what this was like. Oh, I want to turn off skip menu. That's what I was thinking. I'll turn on skip menu. Yeah, so the minimap had these bugs where basically one edge, like an east edge or a west edge or whatever, showed it as you could not walk that way. For example, I think it was there to just to the left of this screen. There was there used to be a flickering area. It's like if the wall was closed or whatever. So that's fixed, basically. A lot of other little fixes already. And I'm going to get into doing some other fixes right now. One very important fix that I want to do right now. I want to make it so when you fight a Verloc, the enemy that covers the door, let's go into the level one. The Verloc is sort of like a switch enemy. It's like one of those things where it locks the doors and then you have to beat the enemy. And, it's a really important thing to remember, right? So if I die, if I'm fighting this Verloc enemy and I kill him, and later I die and I come back to this, I have to walk back through this pathway. That sucks, basically. I have to fight this enemy again because he's difficult. So basically, I want to make it so that it always remembers that those guys are dead if you've already been to the destination. So I need a key here. I need to open up this door. And I want to make sure I've not been to this destination yet and not obtained. Also, I want to take off the bomb container. Yeah, okay, I don't have the bomb container. That's good. And yeah, I'm also going to need to make sure that I haven't been to 00100. Which is the destination. What's up, Boogie? 00100. There we go. So I'm taking that off, so I haven't been there. So now I'm in a state where the Verloc should definitely be alive. And the item in the area downstairs is already obtained. Or not obtained. So I wanna save it having opened this door. No, never mind. Okay, anyways. Yeah, so the Verloc being dead already, and there's a function called create foes. Here we go. If alive and level, remove foes if you've already vanquished. So here's where it removes the boss if you've already defeated it. Here's where it removes the switch enemies. And here we're going to do if this is a K flag downstairs and you've been downstairs, which means that we need to check if, so this is create foes visited destination. equals exit test is valid, and game scene has map pause, exit test, and the map flags. What do we want to use? Explore revealed. Yeah, you have to have explored that area for this to be counted as visited. So if you've been, if this is an area with the downstairs and you visited the destination, it's not going to create this flow. Okay, let's test this out. How you guys? How you doing, Boogie? Alright, so let's turn off God mode, save it again. Yeah, I'm doing good too, man. I gotta get my taxes done though. I've got about half done. Okay, so if I kill this enemy, door unlocks and all that. Now let's test this. If I were to save right now, I haven't been to the destination. I haven't been downstairs. So if I die, come back. Yeah, the enemy's still here. You got your better return back? Dude, good job. Good job. Okay, there. So yeah, the enemy was still there if I didn't visit the downstairs. I'll go downstairs this time. Alright, I've been here. Arcane, what's up? What's up, Pedro? Hey, Boogie, you seen this, right? You seen how, the pillars can be destroyed now? Alright, so, okay. I visited this place. Let's say I die right now. Okay, I'm gonna continue. It should start me back at the same place I was, and it does not have the enemy. Good. Oh, you haven't seen that yet? It's all thanks to you, man. This is your suggestion. Yeah, they do. Yeah, check it out. Let's see. I'll show you this. See? I've heard these a lot. Let's hurt some of these. Good job, Pedro. Yeah, good job, man. That's so awesome. All right, cool, dude. There you go. A little bit more. Yeah, see, so there you go, Arcane. It's still got this one. See how I destroyed this one a bit? It's still got this I destroyed and that I destroyed. Really? I don't think it has anything to do with your seed, but definitely let me know what seed and screen you were on, if approximately, and I'll take a look at maybe why I was doing that on yours. All right, was it in a level, or was it in the overworld? Okay, so I did save because I continued. So if I were to go into the game again, starting at the home screen, I should be able to walk north into this room, and there should be no Verloc. Your breakout game's coming along, cool. Jim is the ball. Yes, Jim is the ball. That's great. Yeah, thanks, Arcane. I saw you replied. I've been working on these bug fixes all morning, so sorry I haven't replied to your email yet. No, you're not in my spam folder. I saw your emails. Okay, so there should be no Verloc. Yes, very good, very good, very good. Let's make sure if I just walk downstairs, come back up. Yeah, everything's still cool. Okay. Now let's double check. Let's make sure if I delete the 00100 place from my map positions, I have not been to that point in the world yet. It should create this foe once again. You got hooked on making music with Family Tracker? Oh, that's awesome! I want to hear some of it, man. I love Family Tracker music. What's up, Azarus? All right, cool. So this bug's done. It now remembers that you've defeated the Verloc. All right, let's check this in. One more bug done today. Let's double check this. Okay, yeah, so this is a very, very simple bug fix. Two lines. This is checking the visited destination. If you have an exit desk, then you've been to it, explored it. This is removing the foe if it's either a boss and you've defeated the boss, or it's a switch and you have the switch item, or if it's downstairs and you've already visited it. Okay, cool. Git commit. Verloc stays dead. And let's check that one off the list on Trello. Okay, so a couple more items I'm going to get to today are attack speed item and double damage item. No, oh, Arcane, no, don't feel like you're, breaking stuff and complaining. Dude, you're helping out so much, man. Thank you. Dude, Arcane this week found. You guys don't even know how much Arcane has found and stuff that has been fixed because of Arcane. In fact, the whole Windows bug there was a huge bug in the game on Windows, and Arcane found it, and another streamer was having that same bug, and so because of Arcane and his reports this week, we were able to figure out what was the source of the problem. It was the sound engine. Switched to sound engine this week, and the game now doesn't crash on Windows anymore because of that fix. So thanks, Arcane. You're really helping a lot. Don't feel like you're complaining or breaking stuff, man. Dang, don't let these other guys on the stream bully you. No way. Mighty Ness getting the drums right? Oh, yeah, drums will come really naturally if you've played them a little bit. And the simplest thing about drums is just to, like, my drumsticks. Here, my drum. Drums are like really easy. So like the simplest thing about playing drums is all you need to do is just like get a kick and a snare going. It's just your foot, your right foot is playing like a kick, your left foot is hitting the snare, and then you just like learn how to keep a rhythm, simple rhythm. The drums are so easy, right? Drums are really fun and easy instrument to play. So if you play drums a little bit, it'll help you write drums on Family Tracker easier. Put my drum set together. Play it more. What's up, Boitarius? Is this a temp buff, Azarus? No, this is going to be a permanent buff. You get this item, which doubles your damage. It's sort of like the getting a stronger sword in Zelda. And there's also going to be this item where you have faster attacks. So I'm going to do both those items right now, because I just fixed the Verloc bug. Okay, so one disappointing thing from playing the game last night, I did in my own playthrough, I got the gloves, and I was like, yes, an item! What do these do? I was so hoping for the ghost sword or something cool. And then I got the gloves, and I was like, damn, because the gloves don't do anything right now in the game. I'm like, this is stupid. The game should at least do something with this, right? The glove and the helmet. Both these are just stupid items that don't do anything yet. So I'm going to make the gloves make you able to attack faster. So you can swing the sword sooner after having already swung the sword. And then the helmet, I'm going to change into something totally different. It's going to be a chip that goes inside the nano sword and does double damage. So, right? Boo, gloves. Yeah, Jules. So yeah, what's up, man? Yeah, that's what. So the double damage item is going to be like a computer chip type thing that you put in the hilt of the sword, and bam, you got double damage. So both those items I'm going to do right now, and I'm going to be patching the Steam update too. So this is going to be uploaded to Steam tonight. Yeah, 9 a.m. yesterday. Yeah, I was there. I see a lot of you guys too. I'm like, oh, look, dude's online right now. The gloves require the Nintendo Power Glove. That would be sweet. I got a question. What is the strat for the brains? The strat? Oh, they're really hard on level one, huh? Oh, you know what? These guys should not even be on level one. Let me fix that right now too. Let's go. Yeah, so the brain guys. They're a little hard, huh? Where are these? There we go, Ray Meeks. So, oh, it already has a difficulty factor built in. So these guys are made so that they're only in difficult areas, but they really should not be on Z level 1. Let's start them on Z level 4 minimum. There's going to be a lot of enemy switches like this in the game because the game's going to really pro as I get more and more enemies in the game, there's going to be a lot more progression. Like in level one, you will only ever encounter maybe four or five different enemy types. You know, there you shouldn't it shouldn't feel overwhelming or whatever. But level two, three, each level you get to, there'll be more and more different kinds of mobs which will become enabled. So by the end of the game, once you're on level nine, there'll just be a ton of different enemies possible. Maybe not possible. Maybe I'll change some of these and make like that only four through seven or whatever. So, anyways, there'll be a lot more variety in the dungeons, but I think this will be a good fix for now so that the Ray Meeks, these brain guys, don't appear in dungeons one through three. Yeah, I know. Green light, right? You get a lot of. What kind of green light are you looking at? How do you fight them? Well, there's lots of different strategies. The strategy that worked really well for me was I had the ice hat, and any kind of ice weapon is really great for fighting those guys because the ice will freeze them for a minute. Or bombs. Yeah, bombs are great, but what's so great about the ice is you can freeze an enemy and then set down a bomb and kill them really fast. Oh, like really bad games on green light? Yeah. There's a lot of bad games on Greenlight. I did my duty on Greenlight for a while too. I was like, no. Yes. No. Or blinking bombs. There you go. Blinking bombs. Okay, so let's do this damage item and this speed item. So we can keep the glove as it is for now. Let's do a chip looking thing and change the helmet. Oh, in fact, why don't I just change the helmet item right now before I so I can get this compiling in the background. Okay, so this is going to be called the chip. And it's going to change. Oh, if I change this, that means that. Anybody who has this item, it won't load it for them. Oh my God. just came up with a solution for this. I can keep this for now. I keep it as helmet and also put it as chip. So yeah, if you've collected this item in the world, it will still you'll still have it. All right, cool. Let's get that compiling. Let's draw a cool chippy thing. I was glad I had three bombs, not so much to waste them. Yeah. Yeah, they're fast. They're definitely fast. They're supposed to be a difficult enemy. I designed all my sketches and stuff like that in my sketchbook. I designed those guys for level 9. So they're supposed to be a really hard enemy. But yeah, sorry about putting them too. Oh, I should check that in actually. Oh, I already started making these changes. Oh, well. Okay, so let's select this layer. Best way to find something if you have like a jillion layers. Let's just turn on auto select layer. Okay, so this is how it looked with the helmet-y thing. I'm thinking this chip is also going to be kind of gray. Defiantly. You've heard of cave blazers? Yeah? Oh, just hit green light. Cool. Chips. Hungry? Let me check it out. Cave blazers. Green light. They're on IndieDB. Cool. It's already been greenlit. Ooh, nice. Yeah, I like this. Yeah, good job. They used an animated GIF for their green light. Good job, you guys. Yeah, this definitely looks awesome. Let's favorite that. Yay, look at this. All right. They went through their green light. All good. Good job, you guys. I wonder, this is created by Rupek. Friend, invite sent. You've heard of, QLab, what's up, man? Yes, yeah, I was playing the drums a second ago. Just trying to, you know, show how easy it is to play drums. All right, let's make this chip glow in the middle. This is kind of weird trying to do this perspective look on it. Dude, I have no idea what this is going to look like. So I got to put it in the game. This might be too small, too big, looking weird. I don't know. So let me cut that into a new layer and make it its own. This will be the chip. Image. Layer. New layer based slice. All right, this is gonna be item, chip. All right, I'm gonna hack it in so I have this item first. Yeah, hell, I'll just give myself the helmet. Make sure that this works with any existing saves. Should work. Nope, didn't work. Either that or it's just not passive. What if I have the chip? Oh, my phone's ringing. Have it now. All right, so man, I didn't load the helmet, huh? I guess I'm gonna have to keep it as the word helmet for now in the here in the code. I mean, in the code part, it'll be chip, but I mean, in the actual item data, I'm gonna have to leave it as helmet for now. I'm gonna make it obvious that I've left it like that too. So this would be a passive and craftable. Yeah, not purchasable. Gloves not purchasable. Boots aren't purchasable. Maybe they would be. Maybe they would be. Whatever. If they're ever sold, they would be high priced. Something like this. Right, so now if I have the helmet, let's give the player the glove too, because we're about to do that one too. And the boots, what the hell? Right, so we're gonna need to change all the descriptions. Yeah, that doesn't really look like a computer chip to me yet. Right, let's work on this computer chip art. Get some inspiration. Brain. That's beautiful. This is kind of what I was thinking, something like this. Right, yeah, something like this. This thing look like. So how do I get these transistors to look right in the middle? This is sort of a purple color we're using for the transistors, but it's a lot darker than. It's a little too bright there. Free parking. Now Borsenveld does not need the points. He's already on top. Going to bed now. All right, man. See ya. Good night. Good night. Good night. Yep, this will be in the game later tonight. This chip. Good night, man. Okay, that looks good. I like this chip a lot better than the helmet. But I've got them both. I want to keep this and let's see. Yeah, that should be the right layer. Cool. Let's render that. Yeah, that looks good. Looks like a cool computer chip thing. Let's put this the right text though. Let's go to strings English. Helmet. Item helmet. This is gonna be called the Vibra chip. Causes the nano sword to vibrate more strongly. More strongly. Is that proper English? More strongly? That doesn't sound right to me. Okay, and then the gloves. Increases. Increases how fast the nano sword can be swung. Why am I having so. There's gonna be a lot more strings to translate, man. So many more. Increase how fast the nano sword can be swung repeatedly. Let me know if you need anything, okay? Yep, gotta get at least 10 pounds out of string out of that. Whatever. Let's start with those strings. I feel like I can't write English this morning, this afternoon. See, I can't even talk English. All right, chip. Vibra chip causes the nanosword to vibrate strongly, dealing double damage. Boots increases movement speed. Gloves increases how fast the nanosword can be swung repeatedly. I guess that's English, right? That's grammary enough for me. All right, let's make these things work. With the gloves, it's gonna decrease the cooldown for swinging the sword. This is gonna be an input system where we use the sword. It's like the first one. Start attack. See here, here's your cooldown right here, 0.5 seconds. So let's decrease that a bit if you have the gloves. Right, Boogie, see you, man. So the cooldown is going to be if you have the e.gear.count k item chip. It's greater than zero, then your cooldown is like, let's do a third of a second. Let's try that at first. And this is cooldown. Trader. Hello, Josh. Welcome to the stream, man. Right, so I've got the chip. That is nice. Let's try it even less. Hey, let's go all the way down to like a tenth of a second. See how fun that is. Wait, is there a maximum number of enemies you can hit with your sword? Yes, there is. So when you're swinging your sword, it distributes damage over the things you're hitting. So if you're also if you're so if you're hitting like three enemies at once, it's taking the amount of damage that you normally do and then spreading that amount of damage over those three enemies. So you're gonna defeat enemies quicker if you attack only one at a time. Just like anything else. And then also you want to make sure, Arcane, if you hit like a pillar or whatever, it's gonna distribute some of your damage over that pillar. So if I like, for example, I go in this room and I start trying to fight some spiders, and I'm hitting these pillars at the same time. I'm actually doing less damage to the spiders because I'm actually distributing some of the damage over on the pillar. So you see what I mean? Josh, what are you talking about? Are you asking what kind of Mac I'm using? I'm using a laptop, man. Okay, so the cooldown, I don't know if that actually made anything any faster. That's awesome. Let's set it a little higher until we can feel it. Gosh, even that tenth of a second, you can really tell the difference. Okay, oh, that was 2 tenths of a second. Let's do a total of 2 tenths of a second now. That's really awesome. Okay, for example, let's fight some enemies up here. Yeah, you can just work these spiders, man. This is awesome. Same thing fighting the Verloc here. Wow, that is really fun! Oh, I love this item! Oh, this is so cool. Okay, so for you guys watching the stream, this is the gloves item. This now increases your attack speed. It basically decreases the cooldown at which you can reuse the sword. So this is me with the gloves. I can just swing the sword almost immediately after finishing. And this is what it's like before if I take off the gloves. Right? Two attacks. Here's what it was like before. Wait a minute. That's not right. Hold on a second. What's wrong with this? Why didn't that work? So this was 0.5. Oh yeah, that's a lot slower. Okay, so what's wrong with this code? Oh, I did the wrong one. Oh, no wonder. All right, all right. It's not the chip. This is the gloves. Duh. All right, the glove. That's greater than zero. We got 0.2. Otherwise, 0.5. All right. So now. Now when I run it, I do not have the glove, right? No glove, but I do have the chip, aka the helmet. Yeah, it was the statement, man. I had the wrong item there. Okay. Yeah, all right, so back to the slow attack. This is how the game starts. You can only swing the sword so often. Maybe you're not as good or whatever, but your gloves make you better. So if I have the gloves now, oh, that's awesome. You can really feel the difference. Cooldown is just way lower. Oh, it's a sweet item. Man. It's cool when you find an item like that. It's just like a... It makes the game feel cooler. Alright, so let's do the double damage item now, too. This is going to be the helmet slash chip. If I have it, I do twice as much damage. Alright, so this has been using... Starting the attack... this is where you use the attack component, the player's attack component. So this is where attack component has an amount of damage it does. It's loaded. Well, let's go back to that attack components, CPP file. So when it's loaded, it grabs this damage from parse life data get child damage get float. Now in render system, there's a function called set skin. I know, right? It's a chip, but in code, it's a helmet. Definitely not confusing. I have to keep it this way so I don't break the game for anyone that's already playing it and they already have attained the helmet. I want people that have found the helmet to have the chip. I mean, I guess I could just change it right now and then people would have to go re-find the helmet. They would still be able to find the helmet again, but that would kind of suck. So at least for this build, I'm gonna leave it as helmet, and then later on I'll sneakily change it at some point. Hopefully I don't know. I'll find a moment where it's just right to do that. Okay. So yeah, there's a function called set skin. Here's rock. Here's a skin, and here's his attributes or whatever. So your damage is always set when we call set skin. It grabs your original damage from e profile get attribute. No, it's profile get attribute. Oh wait, we can just do get float. Get float damage. No, this isn't just get float damage. This is attack dot damage, I think. Default life per container times a half. I think that's right. Let's check this out. Rock text has all his default attributes and stuff. He has his attack component, does attack. Yeah, so this is gonna be attributes attack dot damage. 1.0 is the original. So really the default damage is just K life per container. All right, so if you have if e.gear count k item ship damage, it's twice the damage. e.attack.damage equals damage. All right, and let's set a breakpoint there to make sure that's like doing the right stuff. And also that it's applied at the beginning. Cool. This is definitely being called. I forgot where. Yeah, this is from set hero states, which is from load game. Call set skin and move system set speed. I guess this should be attack system set blah blah blah. I don't know. I think this is fine keeping it here because I do some other stuff for setting up jib here in the set skin. Yeah, you're just mentioning that same thing. Is it supposed to be in the render system? Not necessarily. I guess I could put this somewhere more, but no, I don't really want to break. I don't really want to break. Let's see. I think I did actually call this from everywhere else. Oh yeah, this is only called from set hero states. Okay, so my choice is I could make an attack system set damage. Or I could just leave it how it is. I guess I'll do it. Let's do it. Let's do it the right way. Might as well. It's gonna be a second to compile. Attack system. This really should be called set state as well. Set state for an entity attack system. All right, great. Let's get that compiling. And the method it's calling set hero states should call attack system set state. And oh, you know what? Let's rename move system set speed as well. Move system set speed should be named set state. All right, so let's flesh out this attack system set state method. All right, so we're setting the state of an entity. Checking if it's rock. Yeah, so we're parsing out the damage. Let's set a breakpoint here. Make sure this is getting called and it works. Next, I think I did all the move system set speeds. Let's check though. Oh, I didn't. Damn it. I recompiled all this without fixing that. All right. Let's recompile once again. We got move system set state. Attack system set state. And both of these should be called from set hero state. Set skin, set state, set state. All right. This should be good. While it's compiling, I'll take a look at what's changed in this. We need to add the chip. So yeah, we've added the chip and the gloves. Well, they were already in the game, basically just renaming stuff, making it more effective, making the game more rewarding. So you don't get any more bogus items that don't do anything. All the items in the game actually will do something now. This is great news. Finally, there's no stupid helmet, there's no stupid gloves. There's the cool gloves, and there's the chip, which doubles your damage. Oh, Working enemies. Yep, and the glove and the chip are actually in the dungeons somewhere. Just randomizes, but there we go. Cool. Right, it's indexing. Let's let it index. Xcode gets weird without its index. What's up, Jonah19? Yeah, so the update was last night, but I'm gonna patch the update tonight. So all these little tiny touches here with the gloves and the and stuff like that, and also a very important mini map bug got fixed. This will be uploaded tonight, so this will be the last time I patch this update or whatever, because starting tomorrow I'll need to focus on creative stuff, and I just wanted to get a few different bugs fixed today and upload it all to Steam tonight so you guys can play it and not have these kind of annoying. This is kind of an annoying thing, not being able to trust the mini map last night. I'm like, oh my god, I gotta fix that tomorrow. So that was a big bug fix, is the mini map. And then there's a lot of other tiny little things that have gotten done, and then these two things also, the gloves and the chip. This will be sweet. All right, so okay, this should parse correctly. Oh, I didn't even check if it parsed correctly. I didn't even look. So this should be called also from, yeah, set hero state from load game. All right, so I'm gonna step into this method and make sure that it's actually getting the float from here. There's the get attribute. What did we get? We got damage 1.0. Very good. So return that. Step into the parse life method. This should take a double 1.0. Yes. Times k life per container. That should return 4. Very good. And it would have returned 4 by default. Great. Now, do we have the chip? Yes. Double the damage. That's 8. Oh, you know, attack that damage is 8 now. Let's play. Okay, so it sets state even when I pull out the sword. Wait, let's just disable that breakpoint for a moment. Is the ghost sword crafting bug fix included? No, I haven't even touched that. Let me work on that right now, actually, after I fix this. Okay, I don't know how much damage this is doing really until I try it. Oh yeah, it's definitely doing more damage. Killing these guys in one hit. I think it took 2 hits for some of these before. Oh yeah, and that guy only took 3 hits. Cool. I think before also the pillar took 8 hits. Yeah, it should take 8 hit points. So if I stand kind of in this corner, right about there. Actually, I could turn on my. Yeah. That was awesome. Yeah, I killed that in 4 hits with the chip. Oh, this is definitely a sweet item. So unassuming looking, just a little tiny computer chip, but oh, it's definitely awesome. Let's see that all again without the chip slash helmet. These guys are already easy to fight, or not. But the Furlock will be pretty obvious because that thing has a lot of hit points. So once it opens its eye, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Yeah, so it takes twice as many hits. Alright. And And it should be the same thing for this pillar. It should take 8 hits. 1, 2, 4, 5, 6, 8. Yeah. Alright. It's OP? I don't think it's gonna be OP. The game is actually meant to get a lot harder as you get in the higher dungeons. So this double damage is gonna be almost necessary. Like the enemies should have like twice as many hit points. They should do twice as much damage. Like everything at the end of the game is gonna be a lot harder. So yeah, it seems OP, but it's really not that OP. Oh man. That's something I want to keep on. All right, great. Let's check all this in. Got the Viber Trip, the gloves. Oh, let's do one more thing. Where do we get the gloves? In this, I'm checking to make sure that when I obtain both of these items, that it applies whatever state it needs to apply. So, actually, I can check in before I do this. This is a good enough check in. And in world, there's verbosity. Make it, oh, already is verbose. Yes, thank you, verbosity. So where we get the helmet. Goal item helmet, dungeon 4. Well, that's really high. This is 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 4, 8, something like that. Four, eight, four. Take away the helmet. Take away the glove. Let's make sure this gets applied. All right, do we have an enemy to fight here? We do. I don't know how, this is kind of a bad enemy to try it on though, because I have no idea how strong he's supposed to be. Okay, so yeah, I don't have the chip. Picking up the chip. Let's not test it on that guy. I have no clue how many hit points he has. Same thing with these guys, spiders. Oh, an easy way to test this would be to just kill all the enemies on the screen and fight one of these pillars. Oh, that took 8 hits. Unless I was hitting both pillars at once. Oh, I was hitting both pillars at once. That only took 4 hits right there. What's up with this? Probably because I did the kill all fast. Okay, so it works. It works. What's up, PMC and Jalapenos, bud? How you guys doing? Now it's confirmed that the glove actually gets applied to glove. This is dungeon two. Dungeon two. Is pillar damage split by design? Yeah, all the damage is meant to distribute over everything you hit. So if you hit two pillars at once, your damage is meant to go halfway to one, halfway to another. Same thing with enemies. If your sword actually connects with four enemies at once, a quarter of your damage goes to each one of them. But that is clamped to a minimum. So you do a minimum amount of damage, no matter what, to every enemy around you. So, dungeon two. This is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I should not have the glove. 0, 6, 2. Make sure my attack speed goes faster by picking up the glove. This is an easy one to test. Yeah, there's a definite delay where I can't swing the sword. Yeah, oh, now it's like you're just like wailing. This is so cool. It's almost too fast. Good. Oh man, super cool. Bugs already fixed. Do you use some arc ray casting? Yeah, I know what you mean. For the shadows, no, there's no ray casting or any kind of 3D effects going on in the shadows. It's entirely 2D. Just take the same sprite as the character, flip it over, make it black, skew it. That's all there is. Ray casting is a great way to make your shadows better, though. For example, like you can tell that in this game, the shadows aren't perfect. It's not a Oh, arc ray casting for the attack? What do you mean? I'm not following what you're asking there. Okay, so now we're gonna fix Jonah 1-9's reported bug. Jonah, help me remember. This is the crafting the ghost sword. So I gotta find this. Is this it? Cannot equip ghost sword in a crafting room? This must be it, huh? Cannot equip ghost sword in crafting room. Is this it? To detect enemies when you hit them? No. It just uses regular collision detection. Check it out. This is regular rectangular collision detection. So the ghost. Yeah, I think this is the same bug. All right, great. Look at this. This is all the debug data. It's kind of hard to see on this level, but you can see little red squares underneath all the players and stuff. And that enemy has a purple E square. But yeah, that's it. So you can see when I swing the sword, there's an orange hitbox. That's all it does for its collision detection. Okay, so let's warp the player to 1-1, negative 50. I should have a ghost sword to craft. Let's give the player the helmet and the glove because that's so awesome. Yeah, so I have a ghost sword ready to be crafted. I should have no other ghost swords. Cool. Oh, I should also have an element to combine with. Have you done it so it can hit enemies that's behind? If they're in the hitbox? Yeah, no matter what. If it's in the hitbox, it hits them. Kadao, what's up, man? When do you think you'll be finishing the game? I can't say. It'll be sometime this year. Later this year. Not exactly sure. Oh, you're right. You can't even equip the ghost sword. Oh, man, that's a really bad bug. Thank you for reminding me about this, Jonah. Can't believe this one was not marked as a higher priority. I thought this was on my top of my list, but I somehow got not on my list. So cool, man. I'm glad you're excited. If you want to play the beta, you can pre-order the game at songbreaker.com. slash pre-order. But yeah, I know a lot of you guys out there are waiting for the finished version, and I'm so excited to make a really awesome game for you guys that you want to play the finished version, because it's just getting better and better all the time. Last night when I played the game, I felt like I played it for the first time. I'm like, oh my God, my heart was pumping when I fought all these this huge switch room in a dungeon that I was not ready to fight. Like I was pushing the player, like I was at like level 3 items and I was fighting in dungeon 6, and it was super exciting. So I know, right? So gutted. Yeah, this is about to get fixed right now. So what is it that's not allowing the player to craft the ghost sword? First of all, let's check its constants. Yeah, I know. I remember your name. I remember seeing you a while back. Yeah, I'm glad you're still checking in on the game. Okay, yes, it's craftable, but it's also depletable and equipable if depleted. Okay, I don't exactly know why this isn't working yet. Let's see. Let's go to gear component. Gear component has a function called can equip. And when you're in the area and you can craft, it calls can craft. So it passes that off to here. It looks like that. It looks like it might be hitting this right here. Nice, you're developing with phaser.io? Cool. What's that? I haven't even seen it. Let me check it out. All right, so yes, this is the item Ghost Sword. Let's confirm that. No, this is the sword. Bomb. Damn. Right, let's kill that. Set this the right way. If item equals K item ghost sword, we'll set a breakpoint. Phaser.io, huh? Yep, breakpoints. PMC, I have to make a JavaScript blackjack game. Cool. You don't know how? Where to start? Where to start with blackjack? Maybe do a blackjack tutorial. I'm sure there's one out there. Oh, okay, so it's a WebGL game, Canvas WebGL. Yeah, this would probably be a lot friendlier than Cocos 2D X is JS. Cocos 2D JS used to be called. Good job, Kadao. Cool, man. Right, so we got a breakpoint here. Too bad conditional breakpoints are slow and don't work that well, because now I'm in the habit of always setting breakpoints this way. All right, so yes, we're crafting the ghost sword. Okay, item ghost sword. All right, find the ghost sword. We're looking for from fear sword to ghost sword. Oh, this is going to return the ghost sword, and then it's going to say, oh, you can't craft the ghost sword. I see the bug. Very easy to fix. But I want to make sure this is not the same case for crafted bombs. This is firebomb through fear bomb. That's a crafted bomb. This is a crafted top hat. Fire top hat through fear top hat. Same thing with the blink. But the ghost sword is different. I might want to fix this, actually, this method. Let me see if it's easy to fix. All right, Kadao. See you, man. No one has submitted that bug. Rock disappears? Like, permanently? Or does he come back? Oh, it's just for a second. Oh, no. No one's reported that. Are you on the Trello? Can you report it? Otherwise, I'll add a Trello item for it right now. Is there a certain place where it happens for you? Can you get it to happen again? Man, there's only a couple places where this is called. I hope I don't break something by fixing this, but I think this should be fixed. Yeah, let's change this. Let's make this right. Crafted ghost sword. When I got out from the very first cave, all screen transitions do it. It always does that. Wow. Do you have any ability to film a video of it? That would really help that one, because I've never seen that before on any of the platforms I've played on. Doesn't happen on Linux, Windows, or Mac for me. Huh, I'm wondering what it could be. Okay, cool. What's up, Kofez? Game's going great, man. Yeah, released a beta update last night, so there's a lot of great new things in the game. And then I'm patching the update right now. So I'm going through and I'm fixing up all these little bugs, and I'm going to release an update to Steam tonight. And that'll be it for this update, so I can go and get creative tomorrow and start doing some other new fun stuff, like maybe a new boss, maybe some new enemies, something like that. And work on the next update. Oh no, you can't look at tutorials? Oh. Well, good luck, man. I mean, you'll figure it out. Wait, save and quit, fix it, now you can't recreate it? Oh, weird. All right, so that was all the fixed crafting, but now I gotta make sure I didn't break the rest of the game's crafted swords. So, all right, so we have the ghost sword. It's showing it on my. That's good. Okay, so if I don't have the ghost sword, shouldn't show it on the menu or on the HUD. Good. It's not in my inventory. It's not on the HUD. Can't use it. Say I have the ghost sword and I crafted it to be the fire. It should show the fire sword on the menu. Yep, good. Good. And I can launch ghost swords. Cool. Okay, this does appear to be working. Let's check some more, though. Let's check the poison sword as well. Not sure if someone reported already, but I got stuck after killing the drop mini boss that's supposed to give me the drop. I don't. Yeah, somebody's reported that. I don't know what to. I fixed that bug like weeks ago, and then it came back. So something's wrong in some system. It's probably an easy fix at this point now that I've fixed it once before. So yeah, there's definitely an issue there. Sometimes it happens. Sometimes it doesn't. So really the easy fix there is just to save and quit if you get stuck, which it sucks you can get stuck doing that. Oh, that should be sky so it doesn't. Anyways, okay, so yeah, that's the poison sword. Everything looks like it's crafting well. Oh, if I go up into this room now, I should not be able to craft the poison sword. Or I should not be able to recraft the sword. Because I have one crafted already. Cool, and I can't select it. All right, let's disable that breakpoint. Now, if I take away the poison sword, and I make the ghost sword craftable. Acid, right? It's called acid, but it's called poison in the code. Man, this is getting this way, isn't it, huh? The names in the code are changing, or not changing, but the names elsewhere are changing. Great, I can craft that. What if I don't have, I shouldn't be able to craft that unless I have two of them. Yeah, good. Okay, so let's set that back to craftable. Let's make sure we have something to craft it with. We got fear. That'll work. Okay, we're about to craft the fear sword. Thank you. Hey, Jonah, there's one important bug fixed. Craft the swords once again. Sorry about that. It's been this way for a couple updates. Yes! Really short right now because I got plenty of health, but let's fight some enemies and see if this is like working. That's nice. Look where it put me. Thank you. Whoa, because I haven't bombed that yet. Let's get hit by these guys a bunch. Hit me more! Okay, that's pretty good. Yeah. Pizza guy, is that a cameo? No, I don't think it's really a cameo. It's more of a these are actual characters that are going to be on Songbringer. There's going to be a whole bunch more characters. There's a lot of it's basically a festival. It's a flying festival. The ship is just a flying festival full of people that like to party. Oh, it's because I have the chip. I can just rock all these pillars and everything so hard. Yes, good, good, good. Oh, why didn't that work? Tell me these should work. Oh, that's cool. The Karsh's poison bubbles hurt the pillars. That's awesome. Oh man, the little things in game development that just surprise you and you go, whoa, that's cool. All right, I don't know what's up with this secret not being revealed right there. But if I go down here and check this other secret on my map, I can see it right there. It's like not revealing these secrets. I guess I gotta file another bug. Alright, but at least the ghost sword's fixed. Archive. Overworld secrets not revealed and not bombable? Is that a feature, Wizard? It's an accidental feature, yeah. I mean, I designed the whole pillars to be destructible now, so you know, that was a whole day of code right there, which ended up with this awesome new feature. Okay, this is ready to check in. Ghost sword fix. All right, so this is the method where we're setting the item image. It's looking for the crafted ghost sword. If it doesn't find a crafted ghost sword, but it does, you do have the ghost sword regular, it'll show that. Next up, this is the find crafted ghost sword. Instead of returning the ghost sword as one of the crafted swords, it doesn't. It only does the crafted ghost swords. This is only fear sword through fire. And then in can craft, it's just checking find crafted ghost swords. So that's what really fixes the whole bug with the crafting. And then here in the launch ghost sword, it looks for a crafted one if it doesn't find it. But you do have the regular, it uses that. Very good. Okay, let's check this in. Another bug fix. Another one bites the dust. That was the wrong key for that song. Ghost sword is once again craftable. All right, so I've got maybe time for one more bug fix before I have to stop today's stream and get some lunch. So probably more 15 more minutes on today's stream. Let's see what to attack next. If there's anything that's really, really quick. Unsheath a little sooner to move. Let's do that really quick. Oh, and don't do shield energy if you don't have the shield. These are both quick. Let's take away the shield really quick. How many times can I say quick within 30 seconds? Shield, zero. But if I use a if I use a cactus, it'll still do the shield. And him. Some books to recommend about game programming? Man. In C++, I used to. I read books back in the 90s on this subject, so really my knowledge of today's C++ books is just horrible. But if you want me to recommend something, the only thing I really know of is the old stuff that I read as a kid, which is some books by, I think his name was Andre Lamothe. Game programming. Here, yeah, this is one of them. I mean, this is so old though, it's really, really out of date at this point. But this is one of the books I read as a kid, Tricks of the Game Programming Gurus. It's a C++ game development book. Oh, there's a newer edition though. Oh, here you go. Wait, here's a newer edition. Hey, good job, man. You updated your book. Yeah, so maybe this, I don't know. Yeah, that might be new enough. I don't know about that book, but I don't know. I guess just do your own search maybe and find another book. Okay, I'm getting hit. Now if I use a cactus, and then get hit some more. Yeah, see, it does this shield animation. I don't want it to do that if you don't have the shield. Let's equip the cactus so I don't have to keep re-equipping it. And when it does the shield animation, where the hell is that? Shield. I think there's a method called use shield. Yeah, use shield HP. All right. Yeah, maybe there's something in that. Maybe that book is new enough. I don't know. So here's where we use the shield. Here's a separate shield animation. So if we have a shield, we can do this separate shield animation. Oh. We also don't want to play the shield sound. Or do we? Or do we? We do. This is something important. But the pushback, this should be part of this here. Yeah, so if only if you have the item shield does it do this separate animation and the pushback. You got the bug on the camera? Oh, nice, Jonah. Weird. Okay, I see what's going on. His position is actually coming in from a certain point. That's so weird. It's actually in the math. It's nothing to do with an actual like visual glitch or him actually disappearing. I'm actually positioning him wrongly. I don't know how you got in that state, but really, thank you. This really just nailed, you just totally nailed this, where this bug actually is and how to fix it. So thank you, man. Let me add this to the list. Right. So, Jonah, tell me how you were able to reproduce that. Did you just fight the, did you just start over basically? You start over, you go get the sword, you come back out of the cave, and then it does that? Is that what you're, is that how it all happens? Okay, so I don't have the shield now. Yeah, that's how it happened. Okay, let's put that in there too. All right, great. Thank you. Reproducible bug with a video. Man, this is the best kind of beta testing ever. When you can show me a video. So awesome. All right, cool. Let's fix up this shield and we'll be one more thing done. All right, so if I eat a cactus, take some damage. Oh. I do want him to have a separate sound. call this shield item. And then we'll call the regular shield shield.wave. Yeah, shield.wave. Okay. And then it, when it plays a sound, bool has shield item. So if we have the shield item, we're going to play shield item. Otherwise, we're going to play the regular shield noise. Yeah. Oh, okay. You're killing some creatures. A jib went to the other screen. I wasn't able to get any loot. Okay. Yeah, I saw that happening to me last night too. It should totally fix itself if you go off the screen and come back. Jib will kind of like figure it out and be able to scan them the second time. But yeah, I've seen that before too. Let's see that all happen with the shield now. So let's see, we have the shield. Oh, the shader, yeah, for the cactus. Okay, so now I'm not using a cactus. Yeah, I'm just using. Now it should still happen. It should happen more often, actually, with... Oh. There's notice the cactus doesn't keep you invincible forever anymore. It gives you some shield, but then your shield goes away. Huh. Okay, that's cool. Let's make sure the Roz enemy is also still okay. A single Roz, wow. There we go. So the shield only works when you're still. Here we go. Yeah, good, good. I just wanted to hear that guy make his shield sound. Good, that works. All right, another one bites the dust. Make sure all this code is right. Has shield item. Count shield.
What's up, baby?
Hello.
A shield item. If you do have a shield item, it plays the shield item sound. It only does this separate animation if you have the courage shield, and it only pushes back if you have the shield. But it still does. Let's make sure we. This is. I'm gonna double check this. It still does this animation. I guess it's okay. Yeah, the double mini boss bug has been reported. I might have archived it already, though. Me bring this back from the dead. Oh, yeah, this is still on here. Where is this item? Gotta put this one at the top of the list. This is pretty important. It is already on the top of the list. Put that at the top of the top of the list. Okay. So we got one more bug. Did I check that in? Yes. Right, so don't do the shield if you don't have a shield. Let's see. I'm gonna do one more bug, and that's gonna be it for today's stream. So I wanna make it so when you unsheath the sword, you can move a slight bit sooner. All right, good luck. Yeah, thanks, man. See ya. Yeah, no, thank you guys so much for reporting all the bugs and everything. I really appreciate it. A lot of these are simple. You know, these are really quick. A lot of these are quick 5-minute fixes. Some of them take longer, but really, usually it's not really that often that a bug will take a long time these days. Yes, I would definitely rather have a stable, awesome game. There's too much of that today, I think. There's too many games that get released that are half-assed, man. It wasn't like this when I was a kid when we made in the 90s when we made games. It was you had to make it perfect because there's no auto update. No updating. Right, here's where we unsheathe. It sets render and then move locked. So really it boils down to how long this unsheath animation is. All of these have a delay of 1/10 of a second by default. Want to see how many frames there are in his unsheath. Because I'll either take a frame away or I'll reduce the amount of time per frame. Or I'll set a little like thing in the code so it makes it so you can move a little bit sooner than you actually finish the animation. Yes, we've got that, 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 duh. But really, this last frame, you don't need. Doesn't we don't need to be move locked here because this is actually the first frame of his next animation. Yeah, I think I might actually export all these really quick. Let's start there. This is one little, that's a tenth of a second we can shave off of the unsheath right away without having to edit any code. So I'm gonna remove all of the unsheath animations. Let's re-export all these. Oh, and also I want to make sure they all have the same amount of frames. Yeah, these are 7, 7, 7, 7. Okay, good. So if I, yeah, I'm gonna remove this last frame. First frame too, we don't need that. Oh yeah. Okay, we can get 2/10 of a second off of this animation. This is not needed at all to have that there. Okay, so there's only 6 frames now in this animation. Yeah. Oh, right. Yeah. I know. I've always kind of hated AAA myself. Not really hated. No, I shouldn't say that. But I know what you mean. I definitely prefer indie games myself. Great, now we've got 0 through 5. It's gonna be 2/10 of a second faster. Yeah, we don't need that first frame. We don't need the last frame. Actually, this last frame is pretty clutch for this one. Let's take this out, this first frame here. So keep that last frame. Okay, we got to 6 total frames here. Confirm, good, got 6 frames, 6 frames. Fervor, hello, man. Rest in peace. You don't use it anymore? Let's go with the East animation now. Take off his first frame and his last frame. Good, 6 of those. Looks painful to work with. It's not really. Get used to it, you know. No matter what, every single piece of software I've ever used has so many has flaws. You know what I mean? Things that are painful to work with. So, I don't know. Ooh, that one's really wrong. This needs to be 1/10 of a second there. All right. All right. Now we have the hatless, 6 of those. Last one. There should be 6 of those. Yeah, good. And when we build now, it should repack textures. Let's just take a second here. Do I like the new Zelda games? I haven't played them. The last one I played was the one that made you fish, and I hated it. I hated how it made you fish. I couldn't get past the first fishing area or whatever in one of the newer Zeldas, and I was like, dude, I hate this Zelda. But I really love the latest Zeldas that I've played have been the ones on Game Boy, and those are awesome. And also I love the old school ones, of course. This game is all based on the very first Zelda, of course. But yeah, I haven't played the new ones. Are they good? Are they better? Are they getting better or worse or what? All right. So that did feel faster. That shaved off 2/10 of a second on the sword unsheath, which means I can attack a lot. I can attack 2/10 of a second faster. Let's see that again. Facing south. Yeah, they look good. Okay, let's put the player at the beginning of this level so I can keep unsheathing and sheathing. Oracle of Seasons. Yeah, those were good, right? I'll face east this time. Yeah, that's good. Oh no! Oh, he stayed in that last frame. Was the sheath animation, though. See, and it reverses the sheath. Oh, well, that should be forever. Let's see if that fixed it. You never played a Zelda game in your life? Oh, nice. Right on. Wow, that's crazy. Wow. It's like somebody saying, I've never watched Star Wars. That's better. Okay, that time you sheathed the sword. Wow, that was a bug I didn't even know about. No, it did it again. Damn, what's up with that? What is it doing? Start what? I think this is the only place in the whole game where it runs this. Except for downstairs, which is totally unrelated. So if I. I take away this animation and don't even run this here. What happens? You like him, but you never played him. Wow. Be the stance. Yeah, so it's definitely this part of the code here. Get an M key. Does look for an idle two. Which uses the skin. We might need to call set hero state before we call set animation. Let's hope that is a fix right there. Because that will change the skin of the character, which will change this result here. Actually, this should even happen. No, the key, you want to sheath with the old animation, and then the idle runs with the new skin. That fixed it. It was because I was using that second stance and I hadn't set the skin properly. There's the second stance there. Let's stand to the. There, second stance, sheath the sword. Yeah, good. And then first stance, sheath the sword. All right, great. That's fixed. Okay, there we go. There's the last bug fix of the day. Wow, that's a lot changed. Lot changed for one little thing. All right, but yeah, that's a really, it's a pretty s insignificant code fix right there. It's something I can easily feel right checking this into this patch tonight. This is a faster unsheath. So now if you walk into a room, you don't have your sword out, you unsheath the sword, there's a whole 2/10 of a second you can attack enemies faster. So you don't feel so, I don't know, helpless and useless when you're having to unsheath your sword. All right, one more thing. Archive that. All right, that's it for today's video, you guys. Thanks for watching. Thanks for all the bug fixes once or all the bug reports again. I really appreciate all you guys' beta testing, and also I appreciate you guys playing the game in such a beta state. I mean, for me, it's almost embarrassing just to have bugs in the game when you guys are playing it. I feel bad that you guys are experiencing these bugs. So, So thanks for being those people that are experiencing these bugs and not being mad at me. See you guys. Have a good night. Appreciate y'all.